Being bombarded with images of perfection, it's no wonder we hate our bodies. But these icons of beauty aren't naturally a picture of perfection, and neither are the images. Be it with stylists, surgery, or a bit of imagery wizardry, cameras do lie. So ladies, it's time to fight photo fiction and reveal the naked truth. When Essex mum Dorothy Perlman hit 40, she felt her middle-aged body went downhill fast.
When I was younger, I was toned and I had a nice shape. Now I'm older and everything's beginning to go south, really.
Caring nurse at work, doting mother and devoted wife at home, Dorothy spends her life caring about other people. But she definitely doesn't care for the way she looks.
I just don't feel like an attractive human being.
Dottie hates her body so much, she doesn't even feel like a woman.
I feel almost asexual, you know, that I don't have that sort of va-va-voom or what have you anymore.
But her husband begs to differ.
I think Dorothy looks great most of the time. She looks lovely. She doesn't think so, but I do.
I'm just not a babe anymore. I lost it, whatever it is.
Little does she know, I've taken her body on a hot date tonight in central London, and she's pulling in the crowds.
She's got nice hips, nice boobs, and she's got a waist as well.
I think she's quite beautiful.
The bit of my body that I really do hate the most is my thighs.
She's got quite good legs.
Yeah?
Yeah.
They are fat.
Very nice shape.
They've got cellulite.
Very slim.
They're flabby, and they're absolutely disgusting.
It's a real woman. She's got curves.
I'm just a big lump.
Dottie's no lump, but she hasn't been able to bring herself to look in a full-length mirror for over 15 years. She can't possibly know what she looks like. It's high time she found out.
How does standing in front of all these three mirrors make you feel?
I feel sick. Sorry.
It's fine. Keep going.
It is so horrible what you're doing to yourself.
And I need to strip everything away from you so I can have a look at you, okay? I need you to get undressed into your underwear and we're going to have a look at your body in the three mirrors and we're going to start facing your fears.
What now? God.
Okay.
I need to give Dottie back her va-va-voom with her clothes on and off, and I've got just 4 weeks to do it.
What do you need to do for now?
I've just got to laugh. I've actually got to laugh because actually if I didn't laugh I'd be in tears. I know why I'm here, and I'm here particularly about my thighs, and standing in front of these mirrors only reinforces why I'm here. They are disgusting, they're fat, they're flabby, they're a funny shape, they're pale, I've got terrible cellulite, they're just horrible, just vile things. So.
You don't need to feel like this, because I can get a tape measure and show you that, in fact, you're very average.
I guarantee you 100% without surgery, without diet, without rigorous exercise regimes, you are going to feel 1,000 times better about yourself.
And I'm going to start by showing her that she's added way too much mileage onto her thighlage. This lineup of ladies are standing in order of thigh size, the biggest on the far left, the smallest on the far right, and I want Dottie to place herself where she thinks she belongs.
Right, off you go. Take it all in. The ladies don't mind. Women never get the opportunity to look at other women's bodies. So this is yours now. And can you see how every single pair of legs is different?
Absolutely, so utterly different.
Yeah? Okay, so where do you think, my gorgeous, you might belong in that line?
I think around...
In that one, just okay.
Dottie's placed herself between a lady with 29-inch thighs and one with 26-inch thighs. But Dottie's thighs measure just 24 inches.
So are you sure you absolutely know what your legs look like?
Yes.
Yes? Absolutely sure. Well, you're wrong. So I'm going to take you, my darling, like a gentleman, down the line to where you actually belong. Some sweetness, would you just shuffle along?
No.
That. By putting herself two places further down the line, Dottie overestimated the size of each of her thighs by 5 inches. But she won't believe it.
I mean, I can't get my head round it. It doesn't seem right. I keep thinking maybe you're wrong.
I still don't think Dottie sees what I can. But she's about to find out her body was the highlight of the town and pulling in the crowds. Perhaps the power of public opinion will help her see the naked truth.
Sit and watch that.
Okay.
Excuse me, I'm sorry. Up here, we have an image of a real woman. I think you've noticed her already. Everyone in London can see her tonight.
Yep.
Yeah? Okay, what are your first opinions?
I would give her a 9 because she's got booty like me.
Oh, good. Let me see the booty. Yeah, booty. So tell me, what's the best part of her body?
I'll go for the hips.
Yeah.
Hips.
Okay.
So would I. The hips.
She's got quite good legs.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And for you?
Yeah, curves. I love them.
That was lovely. That was just, wow. I want to see it again 10 times, please.
40% said your best feature are your hams, your legs.
I know, but hearing what people were saying and I mean, really nice stuff.
Now that Dottie realises her thighs aren't so thunderous, it's time for a leg up in the fashion department. It's my mission to get her looking like a sexy babe with her clothes on and off. First up, I'm going to work on those thighs, slimming them down with a pair of trousers. It's all in the cut and not the surgical kind.
Yes. So what we're going to do is we're going to get you a nice pair of high-waisted, if we can find them, high-waisted trousers, which basically will come in really tight around that waist and drag you in. Uh-huh. They'll scoop around your bum, uh-huh. They'll hit your thigh, but just like when the skirts, where the A-line skirts kick out, the trousers go straight down, and what they do is they create that illusion that there's not very much going on down there.
But first, there are plenty of trousers out there that won't work, and I'm gonna show her why.
Talk to me about these trousers.
Yeah. I'd imagine that the stripes going down are probably good, aren't they?
The print is a vertical stripe, but what happens on a vertical stripe when it hits bumps?
It goes...
Exactly. If you are a woman who's carrying weight on her upper thigh, don't follow the rule books, don't go for a pinstripe, because what will happen is you get the little zigzag. Pop those on.
I'm getting Dorothy to try them on so she can see for herself why they won't work.
So do you see the finer the print?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, if it's gonna go vertically, if you do hold weight around this area,
yeah.
It is gonna push those lines out.
It is.
The difference being an inch wider, I think. So not great, but I just wanted to prove it. So what do you think of these? Let me show you over here. Come on, move back, Jamie. There we go. These trousers, I think, are going to be good on you because they're wide-pant trousers, though, so they're going to come all the way down straight, one length. So they're not tapered, which come in like that, which is going to make your bum and your leg look bigger. Mm-hmm. They're not boot cut, which, to be honest, is a bit dated.
Yes.
Yeah, so avoid that one. So these are very hot this season.
Skinny-cut trousers are on their way out fast. They're being replaced in autumn 2006 by wider leg styles in lots of different cuts to suit all those different shapes. For the fuller figure, a pair of wide smart cropped slacks is a cool way to balance out your hippo hips this summer. If you're slender but small, go slim but not skinny with a straight cut cigarette pant to help elongate your frame. But if, like Dottie, you want to hide those hams, wide leg slouchy trousers give you proportion by skimming over your thunder thighs and kicking out at the knee.
All about thighs with you. It's all about making the most of your thighs. The width of this trouser leg are absolutely perfect because your widest point is just there,
uh-huh.
And it's not going in. It's kind of going straight down. In fact, the length is great on you as well. I mean, these could be bought for you.
Dottie looks fab in her new trousers, but with the help of some Lycra, not liposuction, we'll be able to slim down her silhouette even more. And who better to sort her out than June Kenton, Queen of Undies.
Mama June, we need your help desperately now because look, the underwear has got to go. Have a look. What do you make of this set?
To be honest, I have never seen a pair of pants like it. Horrific.
Yeah.
Your stomach is falling over the top. We can't be doing with it. We've got to sort it out, okay?
With the help of modern technology, Mama June's got it all under control. These Lycra support pants are designed to hold in your tummy, bum, and thighs.
You ready?
Of
got my passion killers.
Here
on.
She is.
Oh, and aren't they passion killers? Right, okay, gorgeous. But you know what? Functional. I can totally see what you've done, June, because these are going to control and hold
right,
and smoothen down and help with the silhouette. Yeah, that's perfect.
Dorothy's lumps and bumps have been smoothed and skimmed, but it's all very functional. It's time to lose control and pick up some va-va-voom. Dottie hasn't had a bra fitting for 17 years.
Are your bits covered, girlfriend?
Yes,
oh my God,
I'm decent.
Are, fabulous. Wow, it's gorgeous.
It's beautiful.
Oh, isn't that great? Because you actually fit in it. June, what size is it?
She's a 34D.
What were you wearing?
I was wearing some like a 36B.
With the right bra, Dottie's increased her bust size by 2 cup sizes. No surgical boob job needed.
You see? I can't wait to tell my husband.
Absolutely, he's going to love that, isn't he?
Her bosom's up here, not just sort of flopping about in the middle.
So even just with lingerie on, we're still right. Taking the attention away from the bits you don't like, because it's all about the boobs and the upper torso at the moment. Because if you went for a high leg, a high cut up here,
well, we'd get a lump here.
You'd get a lump there, but also you would bring so much attention to the parts that you hate the most.
I feel different. I feel like I'm holding myself different. I can't get over the bra, actually. And yes, I'm focusing on it.
And your husband's going to fall in love with you all over again.
Absolutely.
How about that?
If I was you, happy. Dorothy, I'd get rid of the kids this weekend and cancel your plans. Let's have more sex.
With her brand new silhouette and confidence, all Dottie needs now is a brand new wardrobe to show it off. But will my lessons in the bare essentials make her look good naked?
I wanted to do that photo shoot, but I want you to do it naked.
Like 9 out of 10 British women, Dorothy Perlman hates the size of her thighs.
Fail. Ugh. Horrible.
And although she's bursting with personality, her dress sense is downright dowdy. So we're going to kick up a storm on the high street in search of this season's essentials. Floaty summer smocks, 60s chic, and brightly coloured pattern skirts are top of my list for a sizzling summer wardrobe that will make Dorothy simply dotty about her thighs.
What these skirts are saying to me, they're all saying Dorothy. They've all got some pattern or some kind of detail.
This season, detail is big, whether it's florals, triangles, or stripes. So don't be afraid to be bold and show off your personality. When it comes to florals, the bigger and more garish the better. A bold print on your bottom half will balance out big boobs beautifully. If flower power's not for you, try a different angle. Triangles and geometric prints are huge this season and can accentuate curves if you don't have them. Finally, stripes. Mix vertical and horizontal together to create a fashionable yet individual look that will skim your hips and hide your thighs.
So, we've picked up this skirt for you. Now, it's great because one, it's got lines on a vertical pattern, which obviously are gonna lengthen you out. Now, everyone knows this, but what's nice about this is not the straight lines, they've got some detail in, they've got some pattern, they've got some personality, and it's quite vibrant. So at the moment, what we're doing is we're giving you some personality, some detail, some trend, and of course, it's slimming those thighs right down.
Yeah. Dorothy's looking hot in her stripes, so I think it's time to get cool with a floaty summer smock.
I managed to pull you this frock. Now, I love it. It's almost like a schmuck.
Smock dresses are the surprise hit this season, in all styles, cuts, and fabrics to suit all shapes and sizes. Short baby doll smocks are a cool look for the beach this hot summer. This high-waisted frock will make short legs look longer. Metallic smocks create a racy look, perfect for a glitzy night out. If you're apple-shaped, this off-the-shoulder style will hide your belly and flatter your legs. And finally, the traditional floaty empire line smock cheekily combines innocence with a hot romantic romp and is the perfect way to hide those thunder thighs.
A schmock. It's like a long dress. It's made out of a jersey. It's got this broderie anglaise on again, which is of course big and hot this season. I'm gonna pop on this little. It's a cross between a cardi and a bolero, which is a short jacket. I'm going to tie it under your boobs. And what this is going to do, this is going to build in an empire line. Do you see what it's done?
Absolutely. Real surprise, because I mean, I was a bit worried there. I thought, oh gosh, I'm really not sure. But
all of a sudden, your boobs and your shoulders and all this gorgeous detailing up here becomes the first thing you look at, which then allows the material to come out controlled and scoop over your thighs and get rid of all the bits that you want to try and hide. Do you see what I'm saying?
Dottie's looking floaty and feminine, but it's time to turn up the heat with some sex, 60s style.
Now with you, because of your body shape, because we want to slim down those thighs, you are so in season this season, because it's all about the 60s shift dress, and these are great for your kind of figure.
If, like Dottie, you hate your thighs, then this summer's 60s comeback is a perfect way to show off your womanly curves. Classic capri pants are perfect for a casual day at work. Go for a dark colour to minimise the size of your thighs. For some Jackie O style on those chilly summer evenings, a feminine double-breasted A-line coat will skim your hips and hide your thighs. And finally, the famous shift dress, perfect for breakfast at Tiffany's. It draws in your waist and flatters your thighs for instant va-va-voom.
So the 60s, when you're dressing women in the 60s, look at any of the pictures, the girls look like girls. There was none of this androgynousness going, going on. Okay, it's almost a pencil skirt, but it's not quite.
Yeah, which I never would have thought
exactly,
I could get away with.
Exactly, because what it does is where it skims you just here, instead of going in like a pencil skirt would do like that and make your hips look bigger, it gives you a little bit more movement, a little bit more room. And of course what it's got this waisted belt on it which drags you right in just here, and it's gorgeous, isn't it?
It is stunning. I feel special, I feel womanly, sort of. It's like saying, yes, I have got bits that stick out, good. I'm really happy about that, because if I didn't have bits that stick out, it wouldn't have that effect.
You wouldn't do it, absolutely. This is you. This is your look, sweetheart. This is your body. Start celebrating it.
Dorothy is hot stuff in her new kit, but what about with the whole kit and caboodle off? With only 1 week to go before I surprise her with a naked photo shoot, her body confidence needs a boost. Using state-of-the-art computer technology, I want Dottie to create a 3D image of what she thinks she looks like, naked. I've scanned in and distorted a 3D image of her body. Her task is to create a 3D image of what she thinks she looks like.
So let's get down to those hams, let's get down to your thighs, right?
Yes. I think they go out at the side more.
Okay, so let's increase, yeah?
Put them up another couple.
This is the accurate 3D image of Dottie's body. And this is the image she created, showing what she thinks she looks like. Dottie's perception of herself is so out of touch with reality that she's increased the size of her thighs by 52%.
52%.
I can't get my head around this.
That's mind-blowing.
Yeah, absolutely. You're not as big as you think you are.
I would not have dreamt that I would have got it so wrong, ever.
Dottie's feeling much better about the size of her thighs, but she still hates her cellulite, so I've arranged for her to get it smoothed out, and there's no surgeon in sight. A thorough exfoliation is followed by a freeze-dried seaweed and essential oil paste spread on her thighs. Let's hope it smells better than it looks. Then Dottie is wrapped up in a plastic sheet to encourage detoxification. The treatment sounds good, but has it banished those lumpy bits without the lipo?
Well, the cellulite treatment, it was actually quite extreme, but it was really soothing on one hand, yet invigorating on the other. But already, I feel my legs look firmer and they feel softer, and it was really fantastic.
There are lots of treatments on the market that claim to get rid of cellulite and make you look good naked. So I've sent three of our lovely ladies to see if they really work. The Beauty Tech Body Balance Cellulite Treatment stimulates circulation and expels toxins using low-intensity electrical currents to reduce fat. Our tester had 6 of the recommended 12 treatments and lost 1/2 inch from each thigh.
It felt like an electrical pulse up my arm, a bit like pins and needles. I didn't notice any difference, but I'm happy with the result, the fact that I lost 1.5 inches off each thigh.
Eperex Mesotherapy claims to rejuvenate by using an electrical wave to push nutrients deep into the skin. Our tester had the recommended 7 treatments and lost 1.5 inches from each thigh.
The treatment was like having those sort of wooden ball sort of massage things. Very relaxing.
And finally, Philips and L'Oreal's Perfect Slim Pro is an anti-cellulite treatment that you can try from the comfort of your own home. It promises to fight against the appearance of cellulite with an electrofirming massage. The noise might get your neighbours talking, but what about the results?
I used it for 3 weeks, and although the skin felt smoother, I couldn't see any perceptible change in cellulite.
No time for a treatment? Here are a few top tips on how to look good naked.
Never slouch. It rounds your shoulders, making your boobs look saggy and creates a spare tire around your tummy.
Always pay attention to detail. Groomed eyebrows, shiny hair, manicured hands, these all go a long way to taking attention away from your perceived flaws.
Keep tired or puffy eyes at bay. Chill used tea bags in the fridge and apply to eyelids for a couple of minutes.
To prevent cellulite and dry skin, eat plenty of fibre, which will stop your circulation becoming sluggish.
Do incorporate some kind of exercise into your day. It boosts circulation, giving you the kind of glow you just can't find in a bottle.
Dottie's getting the full Monty, a body polish, top of the range spray tan, hair and makeup. Styled, buffed and beautified, she looks hot with her clothes on. But how does she look naked? And will she strip off for the camera?
Dorothy, what's happened? Shag me, you look fierce! My God, look at you! Are you happy?
I am thrilled beyond belief.
Yeah.
I really am, I'm so happy.
Okay, well, do you know what? It's not over yet.
Mm-hmm.
It's not over. I do have a surprise for you.
Yes.
I've organised a photo shoot. Now, I wanted to do that photo shoot, but I want you to do it naked. You excited?
I am beside myself with excitement.
Okay, my darling, well, welcome to your set.
Dottie has hated her body for years, but she's come a long way with me. 4 weeks ago, Dottie hadn't looked at her body in a full-length mirror for 15 years. She'd lost her va-va-voom and could barely look at herself with her clothes on.
I feel sick. Sorry.
Let alone practically naked. But Dowdy Dottie is no more.
That's lovely. Beautiful. Perfect. That is it.
Today, it's just felt like the icing on the cake. It's just been an extraordinary experience. I've loved every minute of it. I felt so special. Everything about this is you don't want to be the centre of attention. But when you are, it's amazing. And actually, I relaxed into it. And I felt really good about myself.
Just unbelievable experience. Everybody should do it.
With some GOT guidance, she's transformed into a chic, confident, sexy woman with her clothes on. But what does she think of herself naked?
But there is one little surprise I've got for you.
Yes.
Have a look up there.
Oh, my God.
Yes, you hunk a chunk of gorgeousness.
Oh, no.
Look at you.
I can't believe that's me.
Look at you. How fabulous do you look? How do you feel?
Yeah, I feel great. I'm just a little bit overwhelmed, really. A little bit kind of, oh my God, did I, you know. Have I done that, really? Is that
what
really
What do you
me?
Like about that picture, baby?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not bad. I'm not bad at all.
You're
you know,
not bad.
I love the lower half, particularly, really weirdly.
Look at you.
Look at you.
Well, do you know what? We've got one more thing we need to do now. Now we're out there for the public to see. We need to ask the public.
Okay. How do I look?
Fantastic.
Do you think my girl here looks good naked?
She looks really good.
I think you look gorgeous.
I think you look very sensual, very...
Oh, I like that.
Very curvy.
Oh, I like that
very,
too.
Very sexy.
Very curvaceous.
Unbelievable. Beautiful. Curvaceous, gorgeous, stunning.
Yeah.
Stunning. Stunning.
Do you think...
But we do need to ask somebody else.
There's just one more surprise person to ask. Her husband, Jonathan.
Oh, you're all right. I'm so pleased to see you. I'm so pleased to see you. Good.
You've created Frankenstein's monster here. You do realise.
Oh, have I?
She comes home and she's like, in front of the mirror all the time.
This is what isn't it going. Nice to see that?
Yeah, I like it.
Jonathan, do I look good naked? Okay.
It's honestly. Honestly, she looks great. She looks fantastic. She looks wonderful.
Yeah, are you proud of her?
I've always been proud. I'm still working.
Thank you so much for coming.
You're welcome.
And Dorothy, don't change.
You are the most wonderful woman in the world.
If you'd like any further information on how to look good naked or would like to appear on the next series, please go to channel4.com/takepart.